हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम शुभम एम चौधरी, लेक्चरर एट के वांग इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मेसी चांदोरी। इन टुडेज लेक्चर ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल केमिस्ट्री वी आर स्टडीइंग क्वालिटी कंट्रोल ऑफ ड्रग्स एंड फार्मास्यूटिकल्स। क्वालिटी कंट्रोल अकॉर्डिंग टू WHO द सम of all procedures undertaken to ensure the identity and purity of a particular pharmaceutical. Total quality control will include all those aspects starting with the procurement of raw material to the finished product available at the drug stores and till it is consumed by the patient. Thus, it will include not only the parameters of GMP, good manufacturing practices, but also the storage, handling and preserving the sample till ultimate use. Quality assurance plays a central role in determining the safety and efficacy of medicines. Highly specific and sensitive analytical methods to manage the quality. The major areas of quality control include good quality and nature, physically and chemically pure. It contains the amount of ingredients as stated in the label. It is to be effective after administration. It retains quality in terms of shelf life or its stability. The importance of quality control is to test a drug for stated quality and quantity. In order to maintain both the above parameters of qualitative identification and quantitative determinations, the procedures and standards are prescribed in the pharmacopoeias published by the respective governments of the most of all countries. The methods used for quality control. Various tests and procedures for analysis, including finding and determining impurities, are given in official pharmacopoeias. In the quantitative analysis, depending upon the characteristic of the drugs and its formulation, various analytical methods are followed. This includes physicochemical methods, includes determination of specific gravity, density, viscosity, surface tension, refractive index, optical rotation, and all the types of volumetric analysis. For determining physicochemical properties, use of instruments like potentiometer, conductometer, polarography, colorimetry, spectrophotometer, fluorimeter, flame potometer are necessary. Other methods for quantitative determination will include the separation techniques like chromatographic techniques like HPLC, HPTLC, TLC, etc. Determination by weight like gravimetric and precipitation methods are also used. Apart from that, routine qualitative and quantitative analysis of pharmaceutical products also evaluated for their quality. They are tests like disintegration, dissolution, hardness, friability, weight variation, content uniformity, for unit solid dosage forms like tablets and capsules. Bioavailability studies, pharmacokinetic studies, biological assays or bioassays, and microbiological studies are also carried out for that. Now, errors in pharmaceutical analysis. In pharmaceutical analysis, ultimate results of analysis is important from accuracy and reliability point of view. The term accuracy refers to the agreement of experimental result with the true value, and it is usually expressed in terms of errors. Precision. Precision is defined as the degree of agreement between various results of the same quantity, that is, reproducibility of a result. Sources of errors. There are two main classes of errors which affect the accuracy and precision of a measured quantity. Determinate errors. These are determinable and can be either avoided or corrected. The errors may be constant, as in the case of weighing with uncalibrated weights, measuring a volume using uncalibrated burette or pipette. These are also called as systemic errors. They arise due to instrumental errors by using uncalibrated equipment, operative errors by person operating or doing analysis, are also called as personal error, chemical error due to impurities in chemicals, solvents and reagent, errors in methodology, error due to unvalidated method. Errors of above categories are usually detectable and can be eliminated to the large extent. Next are indeterminate errors. These are often called accidental or random errors. They are found by small differences in series of measurements made by the same analyst under identical conditions. They cannot be predicted and hence cannot be eliminated. Next, the sources of impurities in pharmaceuticals. The substances used in pharmaceutical field should be almost pure. The purity of the substances varies with different factors such as their methods of manufacture, types of their purification, etc. Impurity means presence of other material other than the drug or presence of unwanted foreign particle other than active drug. The impurities may be toxic or non-toxic. Even if it is non-toxic, it may be used intentionally as an adulterant to increase the weight of an active ingredient. Non-toxic impurities also reduce the activity of the drug, so that one must avoid impurities in pharmaceuticals. Cannot eliminate all the impurities. The official pharmacopoeia prescribes limits for particular impurities like sulfate, chloride, iron, heavy metals and arsenic. Some factors which are responsible for pharmaceutical impurities are discussed below. First, raw material employed in manufacture. The raw materials from which these are prepared often contain impurities. It is therefore necessary to employ pure chemicals and substances as raw material. For example, presence of tin, lead, silver, copper, cobalt and gold in bismuth salts. Rock salts contains small amount of calcium sulfate and magnesium chloride. So, sodium chloride prepared from rock salts will almost contain traces of calcium and magnesium compound as a impurity. Methods used in manufacture. Some impurities get incorporated into the materials during the manufacturing process. First, intermediates. For certain drugs, a multiple state synthesis procedure is involved, which produces intermediate compounds. The purification of the intermediate is essential, otherwise impurities present in the intermediates will get into the final product. Reagents used in the process. The final product may contain unreacted reagents as impurities if it is not washed properly. Solvents. Water is common solvent in large-scale manufacturing of pharmaceuticals. This can give rise to trace impurities such as sodium, calcium, magnesium, carbonate, chloride, and sulfate ions. These impurities can be avoided by using purified water. Catalyst. Generally, catalysts are used to induce the reaction. There may be possibility of incorporation of traces of catalyst in the final product. The reaction vessels. The vessels used in the manufacturing process are made up of metal like copper, iron, aluminum, zinc, tin, though these days many of these metals are replaced by stainless steel. Traces of these metals and their ions may contaminate the final product. Atmospheric contaminants. dust, sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, arsenic and water vapor from atmosphere may affect a drug. Decomposition of product during storage. Many drugs undergo changes due to improper storage conditions. If the drug are not stored properly, they will expire before the date of expiry. This decomposition may be due to light, water vapor, air, carbon dioxide, and metallic ions. Deliberate adulteration. A drug may be deliberately adulterated with cheaper and inert materials for the sake of more profit. This will reduce the potency of the active ingredient present in the formulation quantitatively. These practices are prevented by central and state drug control departments. Thank you.